Hey, I'm Eric of E-Rod's Customs. I want to take you through a quick little shop tour of a place that I've created over the last 25 years. And we got kind of a bunch of projects going on out here, a 70 Chevelle that we're going to get done for the power tour coming up here in June. Another Thriftmaster pickup. And in the back here through the vault door is our other part of the garage that we set up different sections for doing different things in here. And this is a 70 Chevelle chassis that I've been building for a while. This is my machining area that I have back here that I've set up just for lathe, the mill, and tools of parts, equipment, and got a bunch of other equipment, drill presses and rivet presses, and also a Pullmax machine that I'm super lucky to have scored a deal on that thing. And I airbrushed and completely created this thing to be this big elephant in the middle of the room that I wanted it to kind of blend in with the rest of the whole decor in the place. So kind of set it up to be more or less race inspired, steampunk inspired. This here is a welding area as well that is set up with my TIG machine down the bottom. I've made all the workbenches, cabinet shelves, everything in here. Done all the airbrushing, wiring, insulating, all the cabinets, benches, shelves I've made from scratch with old file cabinets and desk drawers. These are blueprint files that made my whole workbench out of and covered it with a steel top so I can weld anything to it, put anything on it. And finally got a real toolbox here that I've been working out of a piece of crap for 25 years now, and got a big toolbox, machined and made this from scratch, a bead roller machine that I'm gonna start making some really cool stuff with. And we also made the English wheel from scratch, the anvil out of an old piece of railroad tie, and making this so it pivots out from the wall, it locks to the wall and pivots out when you need it, so it stays out of the way. And this is also a part that's for my basement bathroom that I'm working on right now. That's gonna be my sink and vanity for my downstairs bathroom that I'm working on as well. And then we also have done a lot of airbrushing, and me and my son and Bobby Willard have done a whole bunch of painting and custom fabbing stuff inside of here to make this whole wall and garage door look like a vault and kind of flow into the whole rest of the theme of the garage. So a lot of people ask, what is this part right here? This part is a air compressor sound enclosure. So that just covers up the sound of that big ugly compressor and quiets it down. And that completely dampens the noise on that. But that also brings us into this room, that half of the noise from your air compressor comes from the intake sound on it. So we brought the thing out here and put a air filter out here for the sound, and we quieted that area down, got super loud out here, and we changed it up and put a thrush Flowmaster on the exhaust for it to quiet the intake down on it, and then put a K&N filter on it. Now it's super quiet. Back here is our paint booth area right here that the Chevelle body is into. And this whole Chevelle body right here, this is the most clean, rust-free car I've ever had in my entire life. It has not a speck of rust on it anywhere, with the factory primer on the bottom of the car and the floor pans. And we're going to show you some really cool stuff combining this as well with another project that we got going on. But out here we have the whole machine fab area that I've been working on for years and years and years, making all kinds of old pieces of crap equipment. This freaking shear right here is from 1898. Think about that, people. There's barely even any electricity back then, and somebody designed and fabbed and made this whole thing up in a barn somewhere. when we restructured it and repurposed it, and it actually works functionally perfect. We just picked up this saw and refurbished the whole thing and repainted it, and it's also tied into the central exhaust system. Everything on this whole wall right here is tied into a central exhaust system, and then everything in here that creates dust, including this belt sander that we just made. Check this out. It's got a sweet header on it that is tied into the exhaust system on it, where all the pieces of equipment in here now are tied into the central exhaust system outside that creates dust here. And even the dual miter saw stand here has got a vacuum table on it that sucks all the sawdust and everything through the table as well. And then the sandblast cabinet, slip roller, rivet machine, another rivet machine, sheet metal brake, bandsaw, and the other one is a Scotchman saw, or a Dutch saw, which is like a miter saw for steel. And that was, all of these pieces are just starting to come together right now in the last month or two. And we just have a little bit left to go on this, where all these pieces are going to be functional completely. We've been restoring this one as well. And then all of these pieces are three-phase equipment, which can be converted over. They're all single-phase power. We don't have three-phase power in here. So all of these are VFD drives. And the VFD drive is the speed control as well. So you can turn them up or turn them down via the VFD drive, which you can never do that on a normal single-phase piece of equipment. But you can run it really slow that way for doing plastic. If you're going to be doing polycarbonate, it melts really super easy. And you can do that with turning the thing up or down with a VFD drive. So therefore, if we can take this woodworking piece of equipment, and we're just going to do metal shaping and equipment with and cutting on it of metal, not so much of wood, but now we have the option to do both. So now we have just a little bit left to go to this with adding another light to it, and finish the outlets over here for these pieces of equipment, and then everything in here works. I've never been so excited to finally get all these old pieces of equipment back up and running and restored and everything. And yeah, I hope you guys like what you see, and don't forget to like, click, subscribe, and comment below, and see what we could do with all this piece of equipment.